school. How y'all doing?
Oh, Jules.
Oh, man. This is made by the people who did Dragon Ball, right? Because this really looks like Dragon Ball.
No, I think the guys who did Dragon Ball did Blue Dragon.
Ball? Alrighty then.
Wow. It's about time travel, as you can see.
Ooh, I like time travel.
Apparently the sequel is about alternate realities, so... Mm. And there was a planned third one that never got made.
That's a shame. Holy crap, this really does look like Dragon Ball. Right down to the art style.
Well, I know the guy did do video games, the guy, artist for Dragon Ball.
You know, this kind of looks like, or at least that scene there, it looked a lot like what I would have imagined Pretend Friends looks like. You've been watching that, right?
Yeah. Well, listening to it.
Well, you know what I mean. I haven't seen the last one because I haven't been out of the house, so I didn't have anywhere to listen to it, and just sitting on my ass and listening to podcasts is kind of...
I do that all the time.
Really? I have to put it on my phone and, like, go places, so...
I just play a game on my phone while listening to it.
Alright, fair enough. I'm really digging this so far. I like it.
Yeah. It's a very traditional RPG, yet not traditional at the same time, if that makes any sense.
How so?
Oh, you'll see what I mean. Well, you can make it traditional if you want. There's also a chance to not make it traditional.
I'm still confused. What does this mean?
Well, when you start the game, they're going to give you an option of... I can't remember what they say, but so basically... Oh, you'll see one. It's in the option. It's right away. You'll see it.
Okay.
You'll see it, Jules.
Chrono Trigger. Yes. Indeed.
And you can name everyone.
Yes! Well then, time to think of offensive names. This must have blown some people's minds when it first came out. Like, this looks really good so far.
So yeah, okay, here's the thing. The battle mode, you could have active, where enemies will attack whenever they're ready, or wait as a traditional turn-based RPG like Pokemon, where, you know...
Huh, I'm gonna go with traditional.
Okay, yeah, it'll probably be easier for us. So that way we could actually talk and not... Oh, so what do you want to be named?
This is the main guy, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Willem Dafoe.
Sold. Or Rono.
Rono. Weono.
Wino. Will... Aww. Wilm.
Wilm. That actually kind of works. Wilm.
Alright, well, how do I go forward?
There you go.
Alright, alright.
Or you went back and we have to do it all over again.
Oh, Christ.
No, yay, you did it.
I made him Wilm.
The Adventure of Wilm.
Pixel art.
It is a really beautiful game from the time it came out. The art style is kind of like, it kind of looks dated, but not really.
Eh, well, you know, 8-bit art is a big thing now.
Well, does this be 8-bit, or I think this would be more 16-bit?
Yeah, you have a point. Wilm! Wilm! Good morning, Wilm! Say his name a few more times. Wilm! Come on, sleepyhead, get up!
Like every traditional RPG, you're sleeping.
Lean's Bell makes such beautiful music. I gotta tell you, if a bell made this kind of music... Like, we might just have to have those things everywhere. the Millennial Fair. So that's where, like, a bunch of really young people go to screw around.
A bunch of sarcastic, like, kids are just there. So is this a Millennial Fair? Fuck you, man. You didn't understand us.
Man, I go to this fair ironically. I'm growing facial hair, and I'm gonna wax it. Hey, look, a Keaton. Come here.
Although, at the same time, are we technically millennials? Or
I think we are.
Yeah. So we're making fun of ourselves. That's okay.
Yeah, we suck. Although, I remember reading an article. Finally! By the way, that inventor friend of yours, oh dear, I forgot it. Oh, good. I can name another one. Yeah, I was reading an article where, like, the people that, like, not our generation, but the one that came after it, are now
Generation
getting...
Generation X?
Yeah,
baby boomers.
No, not those ones. I mean, like, maybe younger than us.
Oh, okay, yeah,
Gen Y?
Yeah.
Yeah, apparently now, like, they're getting pushed out of, like, the generational spotlight, and the newer ones are apparently even more obnoxious and annoying. Okay, lady. What am I gonna call you?
She's the smart scientist chick that... So, I don't know.
A doll. No. Smart scientist chick. How do I go back on the...
There you go.
Uka.
Tim Burton.
I wish we could fit more in there. I would totally do it.
You could put Tim B. Hey, oh, Tim B. Who do you think is the smartest lady that ever existed?
That is a fantastic question, and I don't have an answer for it.
Well, whichever one your answer is wrong.
Thanks.
The correct answer is Tila Tequila. She knows the truth about the flat earth.
Okay. Oh, God. Is she a flat earther, too?
Yes.
Aww.
I'm being sarcastic, people. She's actually going to be Tila.
Yeah, but I'm going to make it like... Where's the A? Tila. Yeah. Oh. Give me that.
No, yeah. Wait. Instead of a small A, put another capital A after. So it's T-La!
That's right, T-La! Don't forget that she invented you... What? She invited you to see her new invention.
She invented you to see her invention.
Run along now and be back before dinner.
God, that'd be a lonely life if you had to invent friends.
I feel like there was a joke made, like, about that somehow, or somewhere. Being so lonely that you had to invent friends? I feel like that's a thing.
Yeah, probably is. I feel like it was probably in a kid's show, but they made a joke about it, then they realized they made the whole thing of how sad it was, and it's like... Yeah, this isn't as funny as it is. You think it is, kids.
I'll see, like, that's why some kids' shows are really good, because they do hide adult themes like that in there so well. Now, I don't know where I'm going. I'm just looking for Tila.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to tell you this right away. I'm not going to tell you how, but...
What the fuck? Did I just punch that girl?
You ran into her.
Oh. Wow, he's dead.
Certain things you do in right now will affect a future part of the game.
Interesting.
I'm not going to tell you what does what, but...
How do I find this chick's pendant? Am I able to? There it is! Ah! Hey, come here, lady who, like, fucking drop-kicked me. No! Hey. Wilton... is a good guy. Oh, good. I get to name her, too. Who's a famous, like, Marl? Who's a famous, like, girlfriend of the hero?
Megan Fox.
Alright.
Or
Megan FX. Megan Fix.
Well, no, it's Megan Fox.
Yeah, and besides, she's a redhead. Oh, wait, no, she was only a redhead in fucking TMNT.
I don't even think they made her a redhead for that.
I could have sworn that. Megan Fix!
Yeah. Well, April O'Neil was supposed to be a redhead, but, yeah.
Fair enough. Is this chick actually, like, useful, though?
Or she's part of your pirate party member.
No, fuck you.
You don't have any to trade anyway.
I hate fairs. Say, do you want know the latest gossip? Then what? What? Fucking asshole.
Yeah, you have to explore the fair a little bit, because certain things you do in the fair will affect a future part of the game.
Fair enough.
I'm not gonna tell you what does what.
Well, where's my cat? He's in a race, apparently.
Is he?
I mean, I saw a cat running around.
Is that the only cat, though?
I'm gonna say no.
You gotta press X, like, yeah.
Oh my god, what?
You gotta press X while that's a minigame.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, suck my dick! Go to hell! You know what? Screw you, friggin' afro.
You can also go up.
Oh, I can?
Yeah.
Did I just leave? Oh. What the fuck is going on here? This is like... This is like what happens before, like, the tribal people eat a person.
Well, they are actually supposed to be tribal people.
Fair enough. What the hell is going on?
You could dance.
Dance. This is the weirdest fucking thing I've seen all day. MJ, I've only been up for an hour. I can't friggin' handle this kind of weirdness.
You know what? I'll tell you one place you could go to that will show you the game. Kind of tutorial. Yep. And it also lets you get XP early if you want to.
I don't want to dance anymore. There we go. Well, then. Wow. Like I said, that's always what happens before, like...
So, go completely left. Go down those stairs.
Can do. Hey, you were at the front. Oh, look, it's Kitty.
Yes.
Hey. Where'd you go? Kitty? Alright, then.
You just scared it away.
Hey, I tried to help the cat. If it doesn't like it, then that's the cat's problem. Holy crap. Hi there, buddy. They call me Gatto. I got metal joints. And beat me up and earn 15 silver points. Well then. I'm gonna get my ass kicked, aren't I?
No, it's possible to beat him this early.
Alright, what the hell?
That's his attack. Now you get to attack him.
If you'd be so kind as to hurt him, that'd be great. Good god. Am I really gonna die?
You have two party members.
Go on, attack him. Oh, that's incredibly Japanese. Holy crap, she's armed. Nice.
Soon you get early experience points.
Hey, I can live with that. I lost, you won, here's 15 points. Now, wasn't that fun?
It's a place where if you wanted to, you could do an early grind and just level up like crazy.
But is my health good, or...?
No, it stays the same as what it was.
Oh,
but there's
so...
ways that you could get your health back.
Hmm. Ways like... Come here, kitty. Come here, kitty. It's okay, kitty. Stupid cat. Get out of my way, old man! Thank you. What's that?
Oh, yeah, it was decorative. Now, here's a choice you can make. Oh, you stole the old man's lunch. But your health is back.
Run!
No, it just keeps respawning.
Oh. So,
but that does affect something in the future.
So, let me guess. He's gonna get mad, and... I'm going to have to fight him because I took his chicken.
Oh, I'm not going to say what. Because it's actually kind of cool how what they do for...
That guy looks like the guy in the commercials who says diabetes weird.
Diabetes?
Diabetes.
Diabetes, man. I can't remember his name.
What am I doing? Ooh. Okay, I don't have that. And would you say this is worth it? Wait, what do I have?
You have 400 gold.
Should I?
I mean, if you want to. There's also you places to buy equipment and potions, too, around here.
I'll hold off on that. So you're not going to get diabetes today. Talk to that lady. No! Don't be a douche!
So there's people on the left that... Yeah, that's not the cat.
Don't you tell me what is and isn't a cat.
The cat that you keep scaring off is actually the cat you need to bring to that little girl, if that's what you're thinking.
How do I get the kitty? Hey! What is my guy doing?
Oh, you have to press X when he's farthest away? I think that's how it works? Something like that. Oh no, he explained to you. You weren't listening.
Did I do anything?
You have to try and hit the bell. Like.
Wait. Press X while facing the bell. Judge your distance carefully and then press O. Okay. Oh, okay, I got you.
There you go.
Hey!
You got one silver point.
That's it?
It's not even gold, it's just a silver point. Which you can exchange for gold when you get 10 of them.
Silver points. Silver points.
So yeah, that tent there sells shit, and the other tent just above it sells shit too.
It's grinding time in the RPG. Let's see what you got here. Ooh, I should probably buy a bunch of those.
Well...
Or revive.
You don't have to worry about it right now, because you already ate that old man's lunch, so you could just go crazy and eat his lunch over and over again now.
Imagine being this fucking guy, like... I can't bring a sandwich anywhere without this red-headed spiky fuck eating it. What has the world come to? Man's sandwich is not safe anymore.
I just want a chicken sandwich. Is that too much to ask?
Hey, what are you doing? Well then. What the fuck are these people doing?
The race. It's on, Jules.
Like Donkey Kong?
Exactly.
Suck my dick. How many laps, though?
Oh yeah, you're not taking part in this race. You can't take part in the race, Jules.
Bragging rights!
You beat them.
Yeah, you bet your ass I beat them. Now what do I do?
Well,
have I missed anything?
You could go on to see the device that Tila Tequila made.
I think you mean Tila.
Yeah, the Tila I made.
Good. You mean you want to get some candy, you bitch? Well, go on. Have some.
Give her a second, Jules.
Why did that really take you that much time? And also, what was the point of this?
I think it's another point that will be brought up later.
You did not allow me to get any candy. You're a bad human. Oh, nice. Is this gonna be like... Wait, have you seen The Prestige?
No.
Oh,
it's
well,
about
then...
magicians that switch bodies or something.
I'm not gonna say it. You need to see it. It's on Netflix, I think. Either way, you need to see it.
Great. It's one of those movies where David Bowie's in, right?
Yeah, he plays Nikola Tesla.
And the surprising part is that he actually does, like, not a bad job of it.
He's actually pretty solid, I'd say. Hey. Get the show on the road, please.
You gotta talk to her, Jules. Talk to, Tila.
Tila! Woo! I feel like that could be someone's real name.
Wilm?
Yeah, Wilm.
The weird part is that we named these characters and some of them are like actual names that might be in the like Dark Ages of this. Like,
it almost sounds like a Game of Thrones name, to be honest. I am Wilm of House Flappy Nooples.
Breastfeed all the time. That's what every fantasy needs now, is that chick from Game of Thrones who's always in a movie breastfeeding someone.
I remember she was doing it in The Witch.
Yeah.
And she was doing it to like a raven that was fucking pecking her nipple off. Oh god, that hurts to watch. Hey.
Yeah, like... there's more to do up there. Talk to your
so
friends,
how
Jules.
Was it? Want to try it again?
To your other friend.
I've done it twice now. Is she gonna like? Is like a fly going to go in there and like she's gonna be turned into half fly, like that shitty Jeff Goldblum movie?
I still kind of want to see that movie.
I couldn't get into it. That's me. No way, throw the switch. I want to put my body through a scientific experiment that could totally go wrong and turn me into a freak. I'm going to have to rescue her from something, aren't I?
Yes. The plot picks up, Jules.
Oh, good. Oh, that's good. That looks fantastic. Hey, look, Stargate.
It does kind of look Stargate-y.
Well, then.
Stargate-y.
Yes, that's now an adjective. Doctor? What the fuck did you just do? I was going to get laid tonight.
First of all, it wasn't his invention. It was T-Lau's.
God damn it, Tila Tequila. Don't you run away, bitch. Well. She's so familiar. I know I've seen her somewhere. Stalker. What the fuck are you doing? You just waggling your friggin' glasses? Alright.
She's nervous. That's what she does when she's nervous. Just... I know I got to think of a way.
You're going to do it? What a fine young lad. He's just hammering an expensive looking machine.
He has to make it look like he's doing something. Oh, yeah. Let's
just, Hey, look, she may have made the computer, but look, I'm hammering.
We must look busy. Listen, if we don't look busy, Tila will come in and she's...
The beatings will continue until morality improves. Oh no, it's morale. Oops. Wow, this is like 80s CISPA. I like that. This is like that scene in 2001 A Space Odyssey. He's going into the beyond.
Yeah. Have you read any of the sequels to those books that explain what all that means?
No, I've only read the first book, and I was very impressed. Well, I think this is a good place to stop.
We'll see minutes. You next time.
Oh!
Oh, never mind. We'll start a fight. Well, you know what? We'll come back in the middle of a fight.
Holy crap, look at all the little blue piccolos. Y'all motherfuckers gonna do anything or what?
Okay. We're gonna keep fighting. Jules wants to fight.
Hey.
Look. Jules is a big man.
Hey. Look. When... Hey, I'm trying to come up with something that justifies my violence. I am only human, after all. Don't put the blame on me.
Jules.
That guy is like the male equivalent of Adele.
Yeah.
I'm only human. After all, put the blame on me. Now we're going to say sayonara.